With another month of Terran R development behind us, let's take a look at what's new across design, build, test, and launch. July was a busy month for design, closing out an additional 28 component-level critical design reviews. The team also rallied to release 351 thrust structure fluids components this month, ahead of integrated assembly. With the second stage tank weldment complete, the team is now focused on completing the thrust structure build and welding the stage one tank. The thrust structure panels have been mated and are undergoing torque operations. In parallel, subassemblies for avionics and fluids are progressing, keeping the build sequence tightly coordinated as we move toward thrust structure completion. A first stage fuel barrel has been loaded onto the circumferential friction stir welder in preparation for tank welding. An additional two barrels for Terran R's first stage tank have been welded and are undergoing mechanical assembly. The factory is buzzing with large-scale primary structure hardware as we bring Terran R to life. In engine manufacturing, printed parts for Stage 1 first flight engines are 92% complete, and the first set of flight turbopumps have been assembled. The team has started printing propulsion hardware for Terran R's second flight and beyond. The first stage engine qualification campaign is complete, and the flight engine production is full steam ahead, a huge milestone for the program. The engine has now accumulated sufficient life to validate performance across expected flight starts, duration, inlet conditions, and throttle and gimbal profiles. On the second bay of the dual bay test stand, we've installed a development article of our second stage vacuum engine, Aeon V, in preparation for upcoming hot fires. On the nearby A2 test stand at NASA Stennis, infrastructure is being upgraded to support Terran R stage testing. Welding began on the LOX manifold that will feed the stand, marking the first pipe installation. The stand's electrical has also been upgraded, with an additional 10 megawatts of power now buzzing. The A2 test stand has a storied past, testing and flight certifying the second stage of Saturn V during the Apollo program, and supporting the engine testing for the Space Shuttle and Constellation programs. Having sat unused for nearly a decade, we're now breathing new life into the stand, which will house Terran R stage testing. Back in Long Beach, test stands have officially started acceptance testing of flight hardware. The Stage 2 downcomer underwent axial pull and pressure-proof ATP testing, serving as a final check before the part is integrated into the tank. At Cape Canaveral, construction on LC-16 is moving full speed ahead, with work continuing on the horizontal integration facility and the launch mount. In July, we kicked off fabrication of the water tower and wrapped up installation of deep foundations and pedestals for all the large horizontal propellant tanks. July brought us one step closer to first flight and beyond, with the hardware, systems, infrastructure, and team to support scalable access to orbit. This year, we've grown by more than 500 people across engineering, manufacturing, and beyond, with each hire playing a direct role in moving the Terran R program forward.